My name is Nathaniel Donson, and today we're going to take a look at creating this cool, moody composite effect, very strongly inspired by the Instagrammer Ted's Little Dream. If you haven't checked out the work over there on that feed, you absolutely are missing out. You got to check it out. I'll make sure I have a link down there in the description of the video. But let's create this cool, moody composite in Photoshop and learn a bunch of cool stuff. Let's go. Like many good things in life, this begins in Photoshop. And I've got two free stock photos, this of the herd of sheep in the mountains, and also the slightly out of focus husky. They are both available on unsplash.com. I'll have links for them in the description to this video. And let's begin the process here by duplicating our background layer by hitting Command or Control J. And I'm going to right click on that layer and convert it to a smart object. Now, I'm going to call this layer Tone, and we're going to go Filter and enter the Camera Raw filter. And here in the Camera Raw filter, I want to first reduce the exposure, just knock it down a little bit. You know, somewhere around -1 is good. We're going to knock the highlights down quite a bit. We just want to darken that. We're looking to make the scene a lot hazier and just a lot darker in general. I'm going to push the whites down as well, like -70-ish. And I'm also going to dehaze. I'm going to dehaze to the max, -100. And I'm also going to reduce the vibrance to about, let's go like right around there, around -40. I'm also going to boost the shadows just a little bit, just going to serve to, again, reduce contrast a little bit more. And I'll also bump a little light into the blacks as well. Maybe I'll push that up to an even 10. Then I'm going to come over here to the curves. And here in the curve, I'm going to pull the white point down an entire grid square. So you see we got these little grid squares. And then I'm going to pull the black point up, maybe like half a grid square. So you can see we're really darkening the scene. We've made the sky totally gray, and we're just making it more drab and moody. And I'm going to hit OK. And we want to mask this now because we do want to reveal our old sheep and just kind of keep this as the top half of the image. I'm going to grab my brush tool, and I am going to add a layer mask. Now I'm going to right-click with the brush tool to choose a new brush. All the way down here at the bottom, I have these free fog Photoshop brushes. Again, I'll have a link to these in the video description. You just download them and import them. And you can use any of these brushes. So I'll go with let's go with this one here. And I'm painting with the color black. Now we can see here if we Alt or Option click the mask, there's what we've got. Now seeing how these brushes work, you see we're going to have these sharp square edges. That looks pretty bad. So I'm going to undo this a bunch of times. I'm going to Alt or Option click the mask again. And here's how we're going to create this mask. We're actually going to create a new layer, and we are going to paint this fog onto this layer, and I'm going to assemble it by hitting Command or Control T. I'm just going to kind of stretch it and move it wherever I want it to be. So there's the first piece of fog, and I'm going to create another new layer. Grab my brush tool again, right click, just choose any old random fog brush. All right, I'm going to again push this over into the corner, Command or Control T, and I'm just holding down Shift to break proportion. I'm going to make this fog go up a bit higher there. And I'm going to select the bottom layer of fog real quick. See how we have this hard line at the top? We just don't want to take any risks and make anything show through in our mask. So I'm going to grab my eraser tool here. There it is. And I'm going to do this totally destructively by just erasing that. So I'm down on layer one where the line was, and we just erase that. And at this point, we could maybe duplicate layer one, Command or Control J, and then hit Command or Control T, right click, and just flip that horizontal. That'll just give our fog a little bit of a mix up, and maybe I'll stretch it straight out to the sides a little bit just to mix it up a little more, something like that. Now we'll select all three of these layers by shift clicking the top layer and then shift clicking the layer on the bottom and hit Command or Control E to merge them together. We now have the selection for our mask. So I'm going to Command or Control click the mask. I'm going to hide, or I'm sorry, Command or Control click the layer thumbnail. And then I'm going to select the mask on the layer beneath. And we want to fill this area with black. So with the mask selected, just hit Command or Control I. It's going to flip the foreground white to black. And then I'll hit Command or Control D. And what we can see is happening is we've gotten rid of most of the fog. We've actually gotten rid of too much of the fog. So what I'll do here is unlink the mask from the layer and make sure the mask is selected and just drag the mask down. So I'm going to drag the mask down, 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 kind of until the haziness is affecting the sheep. So kind of something right around there. Now you can see we do have a little bit of a line going across there. And if I Alt or Option click on the mask, indeed we have a line. How do we fix that? Well, we can't really use the eraser here on the mask. The eraser is the brush tool. So we're going to right click. We're going to right click on our document. And I'm just going to choose a big soft edge brush, kind of like this big 900 pixel soft edge brush. I'm not going to paint with black. I am going to paint with white. And I'm just going to dust along this top edge just to fade it together. And just to make sure that everything moves back together nicely, Alter Option, click on the mask, and there we have it. So there's before we darkened up the sky, there's after, and we're just getting some darkening all over the place. Select that black fog layer, and we can delete it. Then select the background layer, and we're going to add a curves adjustment layer here. So curves adjustment layer, and I am going to, again, just reduce the contrast a little bit here. So maybe I'll brighten up the foreground a touch. Then I'm going to darken the mids a little, maybe something kind of like this. And then we're going to open up the dark tones using a levels adjustment layer, just because levels is slightly different than curves. And instead of doing everything with curves, we'll do a little bit with levels here. So we're just going to darken up the tones of the foreground there a little bit by just opening up the blacks. We drag that midpoint slider over to the right just a little bit. All right, there we have it. So there's the image we began with. Here's what we've got so far. The difference in saturation is pretty stark. So we want to reduce vibrance and saturation of our background layer, but we want to do it non-destructively. So again, select the levels adjustment layer. So we're at the top of the adjustment layer stack, add a vibrance adjustment, and just knock vibrance down to negative 100 and maybe even take some saturation out of it too. Let's go down to like negative 40-ish in the saturation department. Something like that looks good. All right, there's before, there's after. We've transformed this nice bright day, well, sort of bright day, to a very cloudy, very hazy, very dull, moody, medieval, dare I say, looking day. I am a little distracted by the light streak moving down the center of this paddock here. So let's darken that up. I'm going to go above all of this and I'm going to add a curves adjustment layer. You can really do this with any adjustment layer. And I'll probably just set it to multiply. Well, you know what, actually, maybe what we'll do is we'll darken it by reducing contrast a little bit. I think that might blend better with our overall image. So I'm just, with the curves adjustment, I am just grabbing the white point and dragging down. You will need a curves adjustment for this. And then select the mask and hit Command or Control I to fill it with black so we can't see what's going on. And then I'm going to zoom in on this and I'm going to use my tablet and I'll grab my brush tool. I am going to right click. And again, yeah, just a big soft edge brush, maybe not quite 900 pixels, maybe around 350 is what I'm thinking. Yeah, around 350. And we're going to reduce the opacity very low because we want this to blend nicely. So maybe around 10% opacity. I'm painting with my foreground color as white. And I'm just going to gently paint over this section of the pasture just until it's, you know, just not so bright. Make the brush a little smaller if I need to. And we're just looking to blend it. It doesn't have to blend perfect. It just has to not be a distraction. So in that vein, we also don't want to make it too dark. And if you think it's starting to get too dark, you can feather it out or you can hit the letter X to make black your foreground color and paint with black to kind of erase some of that effect away. All right, I'm going to zoom out a little bit. And if I shut this off, you can see there's before and there's after. We just kind of blend it in a little more. Just keep the viewer's eye where we want it to be. Okay, it's time to work on the husky. So let's jump over to the husky image. And I'm going to grab my quick selection tool. I'm going to try using select subject because it's just fun and it's always impresses me of how well it works even on images like this, and then we'll adjust. So it got most of him, but it added some stuff up here, so I'm going to make my quick selection brush a little bit bigger using the square bracket keys, hold down the alter option key, and just paint away the bulk of this selection up here. Now, I know what you're thinking. This is a really, really complex selection. How are we going to make this work? And the honest answer is we're going to do our best, but it really doesn't have to work amazingly well. It just has to fit the image into which we're putting this. I'm going to add a little to my selection there, and then I'm going to hit select and mask to bump this into select and mask, and we're going to kind of ride and die with what the refine edge brush gives us. So I'm going to make the refine edge brush big enough to cover those edges, and I'm going to go ahead and paint over this, and we're just going to clear this right out just like that. Let's see what that does. That's not bad. We're going to have to do some manual masking once we get our mask created, but this is going to do a lot of the work for us, which is nice, especially with some of this fine fur. The difficulty is it's dark fur and it's over a dark background. So, you know, select a mask still isn't quite good enough to really pick it out. I mean, heck, let's be honest, the human eye half the time isn't good enough to pick it out. But technology is technology and we expect more from technology. There we go. I paint around that. And I just keep on going right down his leg. Down here around the bottom of the legs, I don't have to be nearly as picky about because we're going to be masking a lot of this away because it's going to be blending with that, the sort of background, I almost said dinosaurs, the background volcanoes and hills and stuff. All right, something like that's not bad. I'll go around. Really, I don't even need to worry about his foot because I know we're going to be masking that off. It's going to be hiding behind one of those mountains. And I'll just come up the backside of his fur here. Voila. And I think one thing I'm going to do before I get out of here is I'm going to zoom in. I'm just going to get rid of this little triangle of stuff. So I'm going to grab the brush and I'm just going to hold down Alt or Option and paint Just get in there with a selection, something like that. It does not have to be perfect. We'll tweak and adjust it once we get it into our document. But I just think it's not quite the color of his fur, and it's going to stick out for us if we don't get rid of it. There we go. Something like that is nice. We really don't need to mess around with any of these other settings. We're just going to go down to here and choose to output it as a new layer with layer mask. That's going to give us our husky that we can drag over into the other document, as well as the layer mask that we can tweak. And speaking of tweaking the layer mask, we're going to do that before we even leave here. So some of this stuff I know is just not going to work. So let's grab the brush. I'm going to paint with maybe 100% opacity brush. I'm painting black, and I'm just going to come in here and just paint away the floaty bits, right? We know we don't want the floaty bits because that's not going to be part of our composite. When it comes to this blue being in the tail, we're going to change the color of the dog quite a bit, so I wouldn't be too concerned about some color casty stuff. That could still, you know, that's still going to look like part of the fluff in his tail. So we can go through and just thicken up or thin out whatever we think needs to be adjusted. You know, down here, some of this dark mess, right? Some of this along here, if a little bit of that furriness is gone, I don't know that it's going to be that noticeable. But if we leave it, my fear is that it will be quite noticeable. And then along here, we didn't hit this with the Refine Edge Brush tool at all. So we'll clean that up. We got there between the legs, which is looking a little, it's not looking the greatest, but we'll just, we'll add a little bit of kind of fade and darkness back into there. I'm just using the brush tool and painting with 30% opacity. So it's really weakening the brush so I don't just bring back the full-on background, just sort of shades of the background. And I might do the same with that right in here just to kind of, bridge the gap, but make it look semi-opaque in the process so it doesn't look super-duper fake. I think I am ready to drag this over to our document. It's not perfect, but I think it's close enough for our purposes. Again, if you're going to be doing this project at home and you don't have the time constraint of recording a tutorial and trying to keep it, at a reasonable amount of time, spend as much time as you need to get the selection as good as possible. But you can see, pretty good, and we're going to clean it up a little bit more here in just a moment. So the first thing I'm going to do is Command or Control T and scale him down a little bit. I'm going to hold down Alt or Option as well to just kind of scale him toward the middle. Now you may be thinking, convert it to a smart object before you do this and don't lose that detail. You're right. My only issue is I should have converted the layer to a smart object over here before masking it. So I want to preserve that mask. Now I could drag the mask to a new layer, convert it to a smart object, yada, 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 but we're just doing it this way. We're going to do it a little destructively. So I'm going to put him in here and I almost want to tip him over a little bit into the mountain. So he kind of looks like he's bending himself around the mountain to get a look at these sheep. And you can almost imagine him salivating, thinking about some mutton. There we go. We're going to drop him in. I think I'm just going to leave him kind of like that. Every time I think I have it just perfect, I adjust it just a little bit. There we go. I think something like that'll work. I'm going to commit that change. And what I'm going to do at this point, I'm going to Alt or Option click on the mask. And first things first, I'm going to use the rectangular marquee tool, and I'm just going to fill all this other area with black just so I don't accidentally mess something up. So I'm going to fill this with black. Just like so, Command or Control D to deselect. And then I'm going to Alt or Option click out of the mask again. You can see we haven't changed anything per se. I'm going to grab the brush tool. We're going to set the brush to the soft light blend mode. I'm going to go with like 50% opacity in the brush tool right there. And I'm going to paint with black. Now I'm going to zoom in, and this is going to be the way for me to kind of clean up the fur a little bit more, just kind of make it blend in a little bit more by getting rid of some of that fringing and some of that, extra hairiness that just isn't looking right. Is it going to do some damage to the husky, the wolf, who's playing our wolf? Yeah, it's going to do a little bit of damage to him, but we're actually going to be masking away a lot of the edges of him in an effort to make it look like he is emerging from the fog. All right, so we've got our pup there, and I want to do the preliminary masking him in place, and I'm going to do that by getting rid of his front leg as though it's behind the mountain, and also cleaning up the rear leg, and then also cleaning up the front legs. So we're here in the same mask, but I think I'm going to group this, so I'm going to drag that into this group, and I'm still going to call this group Husky. The reason I'm doing it this way is because I want to have two masks attack the same layer, but like this masking of him into the frame is not the same as masking and getting him off of the background. Now, maybe you're screaming at me, you could convert it to a smart object. That would wrap the mask within. You're right, but I also don't want to have to double click within a smart object to adjust the mask again. I want to be able to just get it and see exactly what's going on in my document. So we're going to do it this way. And what I'll do, grab my brush tool, make sure the opacity is at 100%, make sure that the mode of the brush is normal. And we're just going to paint with black, get rid of the legs, to the point where they go past where we want them to go. So the front paws are going to tuck behind this front ridge here. The rear leg obviously is going to tuck behind the mountain. So now at this point, we're going to paint white and bring back his leg. So I'm going to grab my brush tool. I'm going to make it smaller. I'm going to right click. I'm going to get rid of some of the hardness. So we'll make it like 80% hard or so. And this is where if we just worked on the original mask, right? If I was in here and I started painting white out here, well, I bring back my background. So this is one of the advantages to splitting the masks, because now we paint white, we're only going to bring back the bits that are masked as we have them in the mask on the actual husky layer. So I can bring this down, bring it over, and there we have his leg. Great. And then for his front legs, we're going to tuck them behind this hill here, and then the front sort of this ridge right along here. And this does not have to be perfect. You know, as long as it's close enough, it's going to look pretty decent. And, you know, considering the fact that we're going to add shadows and do a little dodging and burning and, you know, toning, things like that, it's really going to begin blending in here. So I need to match both brightness and contrast. A couple things we can do here. I think the way that I'm going to approach this is just using a simple levels adjustment. But before I do that, I'm going to apply a black-white adjustment layer just to give me this view mode of black and white. We can see the blacks on him. They're just much blacker than the darkest black in our image. And the whites on him are just much brighter than the lightest whites in the image. And he's overall just too bright. So I'm going to select the husky layer here. I'm going to add a levels adjustment. So there's our levels. And I can call this brightness adjust husky. And we're going to begin by just lifting the shadows. So we're going to lift the shadows, but you can see it's doing it to the entire image, right? Let's just reset that. We're going to click this here to clip this levels adjustment to the group of layers beneath it, which means that this levels adjustment is only going to affect the husky layer or any layers we drag into this husky group. So now when we lift the black point on our husky, you can see that it's only affecting the husky. So something like that. And then we're going to lift the white output point, which again, I'm saying lift, but it's actually darkening. So I want the snoot on of his nose area to roughly match the brightness of the backs of the sheep. Now, of course, I could, as I've shown in other tutorials, I could use the eyedropper tool and I could sample a point on the sheep's back and just sample a point on his nose and compare them as we go. I'm not going to do that here, though, because I just want to move through it. So reduce contrast, and I need to make the wolf a little bit darker. So I think something like that is about what we want. If I shut off black white, you can see now he fits into the scene much better. That his color is still off. We can delete the black white adjustment. We can and real quick, because it's levels, we can always double click on this and say, you know what, we actually want more contrast, or we need to pump up the blacks in him, or we need to, you know, make him brighter or whatever it is. You can do any of that because it's a levels adjustment layer. I am going to hunt out the color difference here and get rid of the blues and stuff in the dog. And I'm going to do that using an old trick, which is the solid color layer. And we are going to fill this layer with 50% gray. Voila. And we're going to set it to the blend mode of luminosity. Now, what we can see here is generally the lower half of the image has a lot of green and yellow in it. The top half of the image is more blue magenta, right? You can see a clear distinction between like this front half where all the grass is and the top half. So we probably want to shift it a little bit. Now, I know you're thinking, well, duh, of course there's green in the foreground. There's all this grass. And you're right. I still want to push a little bit of green into the sky just to sort of force cohesiveness. So I'm going to add a color balance adjustment layer. Again, I'm not going to clip it to the wolf, actually. We're going to just paint this into the sky area. So I'm going to select my layer mask for this. Well, here's how we're going to do it kind of extreme. So I'm going to go like very green, very red, very yellow, something like this so we can see it. And I'm going to select the layer mask. I'm going to grab my brush. I just want a huge soft edge brush. So maybe about 2000, but maybe like 500-600 pixels and zero hardness. Ooh, I need more than that. Let's go 1200 in the brush size department, something like that. And then I'm just going to paint with black and paint away the bit of this color balance layer that's going to be affecting the foreground of the image. So something like that. Great. And now I'll select color balance. I'm going to reset it because that's a ridiculous color change. And I can even turn on the color fill layer because this color balance layer is operating beneath it. And I could just begin introducing some green, maybe a little yellow, maybe a little red. Go to like the highlights, introduce a little yellow, introduce a touch of green, maybe go to the shadows as well, a little yellow, a little cyan, a little red, maybe a little red, something like that. And you can see before and after. We've just helped pull everything together. I think it's a little too strong for the sky. According to our gray layer, it's really close, but there still should be the distinction between foreground and sky. So I think I'm just going to reduce the opacity of the color balance layer, maybe to like 50%, and I can delete my solid color fill layer. Okay, so now we want to begin dodging and burning the image overall and just kind of painting some shadows in for him and making him look, making it look a little bit more realistic. So we're going to begin with creating a new layer, and this is going to be our shadow number one. So I'm going to call this shadow one, and this is where it's going to be different probably for everybody who does this tutorial, but we just want to have a little fun with it. So I'm going to go poly lasso tool, set my feather to zero. We'll add feathering later if we want it, and I'm going to create a shadow coming off of his back leg, maybe up over this way. I know what you're thinking. This is a very cloudy day, and there probably wouldn't be a shadow. You're probably right about that. No, you're not probably right about that. You're very right about that. That being said, I still want to add one because I just think it's going to help sell the effect a little bit more. So on shadow one layer, Alt, Backspace, Option, Delete to fill our selection with black. Commander, Control, D to deselect. I'm going to go Filter. I'm going to set this to a Gaussian Blur. Let's give, maybe I'm thinking 25. Maybe I was thinking kind of 40 when I entered in, but I saw 25. Let's go 40 pixels of Gaussian Blur and Filter and Blur and Motion Blur. And we'll go about the angle of the hill. I'm going to guess like negative 22. And let's go maybe 1,000 pixels in terms of the length of the blur. That's kind of cool. And I'm going to take this, I'm going to drag it back toward the husky just a little bit. Commander, Control, T. I'm going to rotate it a little bit more. Maybe something kind of like that. I'm going to hit Enter or Return. And then I'm going to try setting this to, like, I don't know, soft light. Yeah, that's not bad. Now, obviously, it's way too strong, so we're going to reduce the opacity down, down, down. And I'm also going to apply a layer mask to this layer. Grab my brush tool, huge brush. We want to go with like 20% opacity. We want it to be very weak. We're painting with black, and we're just going to begin just fading the shadow into the grass, right? So I'm trying to make sure there's no weird hard edges, and it's just something that's coming off of the husky. Again, just suggesting there's a little bit of a shadow there that he's creating. Now, that being said, if the shadow is going to be coming from the front of him, the front half of him should be a little more shadowy. So let's clip a layer here to above our brightness adjustment. So we're going to go new layer, and I'm going to go Command Option G. That's Control Alt G on the PC. And I'm going to call this layer shadow. Let's go shadow zero for this because it is technically a little lower. Shadow underscore zero. And we're going to fill this layer by going Edit Fill. We're going to fill it with, you guessed it, 50% gray. And I'm going to set it, look at that, see, because we clipped it to the husky, it only affects the husky, even though the entire layer is filled with gray. We're going to go to the overlay blend mode. I'm going to grab my dodge and burn tools, specifically the burn tool, and I'm going to set the exposure to like 10%, very low. And then I'm just going to gently paint on the side of the husky, the side of him that's facing us, and I'm going to just darken, darken, darken all of this underside of him. And the front side in general. I don't want to do much on the outside. If anything on the outside, I'm going to hold down Alt or Option and add a little bit more light out there. But we're going to be masking some of that in just a second, so I'm not going to be too terribly concerned with that. And I think that's not too bad. Maybe he's got a little too much shadow in the back, so we'll put a little more shadow in the front, something like that. And of course, if it's just too strong for you, you can A, blur it a little bit. So we could go Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. That'll kind of soften the transition between that and the stuff around it. That actually might not be a bad idea to do kind of regardless. Hit OK. And after you blur it, just reduce the opacity a little bit. And there we have it. We've added some shadow to the side of him. Begin adding some shape to him as well. But the hills are too bright, so we need to do some overall dodging and burning as well. So this is where shadow 3 comes into play. We're going to go shadow 3. Or no, this is actually shadow 2. What am I thinking? Because we started at shadow 0. There we go, shadow 2. And once more, we'll go edit fill. Fill it with 50% gray, and set it to a blend mode of overlay. And we want to do this kind of carefully here. So we're going to grab our burn tool, and I'm going to just begin kind of touching the top of the hills here, especially the part that's almost touching his legs and just being under him in general. We want that area to match shadow intensity-wise the shadow that he has on his body. So we need to go in there and really shadow things up. I'm really kind of going extreme here, but we're just going to try to fade all this together a little bit, and we'll mask away what we have to mask away. You can see how black we're making it, right? We can begin to reduce the opacity, right? Just reduce that opacity, make it look a little bit more proper. And of course, we go in, and there shouldn't be a shadow in the sky. So how do you erase dodging and burning? Well, you grab your brush tool, and you set your foreground color to 50% gray, and you just paint 50% gray on that layer again. We're going to come in here. I'm just going to make my brush a bit smaller. I'm going to set my opacity to maybe like 80%. I'm painting with that 50% gray. I'm just going to come through here. Voila. Paint away some of that shadow. Just kind of clean that up a bit. And the same thing out here, right? We've got all this shadow that, you know, there shouldn't be shadow on the sky. There's not shadow on the sky in real life. So we'll go through and just clean that stuff up a little bit. just as best we're able. Well, I shouldn't say as best we're able, as best I'm able to do quickly here for the sake of this tutorial. So something like that, that's kind of cool. And if you wanted and it was still looking a little funky, you could go and add a fourth shadow, which is actually going to be shadow 3 for us here. And a fun thing to do is take something like your lasso tool and kind of loop the area, right? Something like that. And feather the selection a lot. So we'll go select, modify, feather, and we'd feather this, ooh, like 40 pixels probably, something kind of a lot. We set our foreground and background color back to black and white by hitting the letter D. Grab your gradient tool and choose a foreground to transparent gradient here. So just go with a foreground to transparent gradient, and then we would just go in here and say, give me another dose of blackness in there. Set this to soft light, and then we would just begin masking this until it kind of blended in. So I would probably go with like a 50% opacity brush, make the brush quite a bit bigger. I'm painting with black, and then just go through this and just paint over it until it kind of blends together, sort of the way that you think it should blend together. So again, we're just adding a little bit more shadow in there. I want to go back to the dodge and burn we used on him because we need to add a little bit more burning to his front paws here. So I'm going to grab my burn brush, and I'm just going to darken up those front paws a little bit more. Whoop, I want to make my brush a little smaller. And I'm just going to darken up those front paws. Just they're a little distracting the way they were. Something like so, because remember, they are going to be underneath his chin a little. So something like that's probably a little bit better. And, you know, some parts, like, that's a little bit too dark in there, right? The ridge or the ground should be darker. And that's probably, yeah, part of it is our shadow. So maybe I could go in there with the burn tool, hold down Alt or Option, and just run a couple quick strokes over it. Holding down Alt or Option when you're using the dodge or burn tool uses the opposite tool. So when you're doing burning, it does dodging and vice versa. So hold down Alt or Option and just kind of, you know, touch up stuff like that. That's just getting a little bit too dark. And again, we don't really have the time to make it perfect here, but we're going over the ideas of what we're doing. So we've added some shadow here for the pup. And let's go back and mask the dog to make him look like he's blending into the sky a little bit. So here I am going to actually group this stuff up yet again. So I'm going to select the husky layer and the stuff clipped to it, right? We've got all that stuff. We're going to encapsulate it in a group, Commander Control G. I'm going to call this husky again. I'm not going to call it husky again. I'm going to call it husky. And I'm going to add a layer mask to this group. And now I'm going to use a very large soft edge brush, and I'm probably going to set it to like 20% opacity. And I'm just going to begin dabbing away at him. So we're just going to sort of make him begin to disappear, just the very edges of him. Maybe make my brush a little bit smaller, right? Because the idea is he's coming through the fog at these sheep, and they don't really know what's about to hit them. I'm going to bring this leg back entirely here. And this is, again, another advantage to having this mask up on its own layer. We're just blending the husky. And you can see all that complex selection stuff on the tail. It's really not going to matter too much here because we're going to make a lot of those edges just disappear entirely. So there we have it, something like that. I think that's probably going to be decent for us. Something kind of like that will be cool. So you can see there's before we blend him, there's after. And you can, again, spend as much time as you think needs to be spent making this perfect, because this is a big three-dimensional element, or fake three-dimensional element, that we have going on right here. So now it's time to begin adding some fog, and we're going to use that same kind of gradient to transparent effect that we did before. Let's create a new layer, and we're going to call this Fog 1, and I'm going to grab my lasso tool, and we're going to add the first bit of fog kind of right through here, right? Something kind of like that. And I'm going to grab my gradient tool. We're going to go foreground to transparent, but I'm going to hold down my Alt or Option key, and I'm going to sample color from the sky up here. Or you could sample a color off a sheep's back. You know, you want something that's reasonably light. And I'm going to just drag some fog through here. Let's see, how should I do this? Maybe something kind of like that. Well, what I forgot to do was feather my selection. So we'll go select, modify, feather. And I want to feather this a lot. I'm going to go, I think, 100 in the feather department here. And let's try this again here. We're going to feather, or we're going to add that smokiness. There we go, something like that. Commander Control D. And of course, we are going to mask this like crazy. So go ahead, add a layer mask. We're working with our same brush, painting with foreground color set to black, opacity of 20, and then just begin painting this away. So we're just looking to add a little bit of fog here to the middle of the scene. It's going to help kind of temper the shadow a little bit and just keep things sort of interesting for us before we get the real fog moving in here. This is where the fog brushes are going to come into play for us. We're going to hit add a new layer, and we're going to add a few layers of fog. I am going to probably use that same color. Maybe I'll mix that with some white. We're going to go brush, right click, and move down and just pick up. You can just pick any old fog pattern. It's really not going to matter that much. And we are going to just click once, because of the way this brush works. Well, we want to set our brush's opacity back to 100. Click once, and I'm going to hit Command or Control T, and we're going to just do that old stretching game where we just stretch the fog out over the scene, just like so. Great. We got one layer of fog. We're going to add another layer, and this is going to be fog 3. And I am going to right-click. I'm going to choose a different brush. If I can right-click, there we go. I'm going to choose this brush here, and I'm going to just click Command or Control T. I'm going to move it down, and I'm going to hold down Shift and stretch it out. I think I messed up the brush a little bit. Let's try stretching it out a little bit more. And there we go, something like that. You can see a lot of fog. I'm going to just quick fix this here, guys. Fix my little mistake. And I think that might be enough, actually. I think I'm going to add one more layer, and we're just going to mix opacities here. So I'm going to go fog 4, not fogo, fog 4. There we have it. And I'm going to make this one white. And again, right click and right click. Right click as many times as you have to until it works. I'm going to just go back to using my trackpad. There we go. And let me see. Let's go with maybe like this fog here. That looks kind of cool. I'm going to click a single time. I'm going to hit Command or Control T. And I'm going to hold down Shift, and I'm just going to stretch it. I held down Alt or Option there for a second. That's what you saw. You can see this is going to add a lot of fog to the middle of our document. Maybe I'll set this to something like Screen or Soft Light. What does that look like? That's not too bad. And yeah, I'll just begin reducing opacity, like knock each of them down to, I don't know, 40, 50%. How does that look? 40-ish, 50-ish percent. That's not too bad. If I shut off the fog, there it is before the fog. There it is after the fog. So we're really, we're adding a lot more atmosphere to our scene. We should add a little noise to each of these fog layers because they're just perfectly smooth and not looking great. So on each of the fog 2, 3, 4 layers, let's add just a very little bit of noise. We'll go filter noise, add noise. It's not my favorite way to add noise, but it'll work for this. We'll add like 3% Gaussian monochromatic noise. Hit OK, and then you just select Fog 3, hit Command or Control F, hit select Fog 4, Command or Control F. So it's just adding a very little bit of grain. You're not going to notice any difference. It's totally a subliminal thing where it sort of accumulates, and you'll notice it as time goes on if you don't do that. So it's time to cut through some of these fog layers. We're going to do that by holding down Command Shift Option E, that's Control Shift Alt E. I'm popping this up onto a new layer, and I'm going to name this layer. I can probably put my tablet away for a quick second here. I'm going to name this layer Dehaze, as ironic as that is, because we just created all the haze. I'm going to right click and convert this to a smart object, and we're going to jump out to Camera Raw. We're not really going to do a ton of dehazing, but it's going to sort of have a little bit of that effect, but it's going to bring out the details we want. All right, let's make it a little bit more orange. Let's go like 20 in the temperature department and maybe a little bit of green. Let's go negative 10 in the tint department. I'm going to reduce the exposure maybe like a third stop. So I'm going to go minus 0.3. I am going to boost contrast a little bit. Maybe I'll bump that up about 30. I'm going to add some clarity. So here, this is sort of the dehaze that I was talking about. So it's not really dehaze, but it's just a mid-tone punch more than anything. And you know what? Maybe we'll add just a little bit of dehaze in there, maybe like 25. You can see, though, it's still keeping all of our misty fog in place. I like that. I'm going to go into my curves. I'm going to go to the red channel. I'm going to bump maybe a little bit of red up in there, and I'll pull the bottom point over to add cyan to the darker parts of the image. Then I'm going to go down to the blue channel, and I am going to add a little bit of yellow by pulling down on the blues. Maybe I'll add a tiny, tiny bit of blue into the shadows by lifting the bottom point there. I could sharpen the image at this point, but I really don't want to. Maybe what I'll do is go to effects and add some grain here, make it some big grain, and I'm going to hit OK, because this layer is really more of a color treatment layer. We're going to reduce the opacity of this just until it looks good. So we're kind of mixing our two images together. Maybe I'll keep this between 50 and 55. I think that looks pretty nice. And one of the last things I want to do before a final sharpening and grain is I want to replace the husky's eyes with more of like a, you know, cyborg husky here. So let's grab our pen tool. I'm just going to create a path. Maybe actually I'll make a shape. Let's go with the shape. And I am going to draw out just a selection that kind of fits within his eye. I'm going to hold down Alt or Option here, and I'm going to pull a point back, hold down Alt or Option to join it off, and just create a nice little shape. Now, we don't want stroke. We don't want any stroke. So I'm just going to go and select, get rid of the stroke altogether and just fill the shape with white. There we have it. There's one eye. I'm going to hold down Alt or Option. You can see we've got the shape layer. Hold down Alt or Option and drag the eye across for a second eye. Hit Command or Control T, right click, choose Flip Horizontal. And at this point, we'll move it into place and you can just adjust the size exactly as you need it. So if you need to adjust it a little bit and it's not quite perfect, by all means, do that with your Husky. Then we're going to select both these shapes, hit Command or Control E, merge them together. And then I'm going to right click and convert them to a smart object. I'm going to double click and name this Eyes. And I'm going to save this first copy of the eye. So I'm going to hit Command or Control J. And I'm going to take the second copy here and I'm going to begin blurring it. But I only want to blur it a little bit at a time. So I'm going to go Gaussian blur, maybe like 5 pixels. So there's 5. That's kind of cool. I'm going to hit Command or Control F. And maybe we'll go 5 again. And that's kind of cool as well. That's probably about what I want. I'm going to turn on the original eyes. We can see that's what they look like. We need to make these eyes a little bigger. So I am going to duplicate this layer, Command or Control J, a couple times. And let's do Command or Control J once. We're going to double click on one of these Gaussian blurs and up it from 5 to like 15. So let's go 15. Okay. I'm going to select the other Gaussian blur. It's going to shut off some previews. I'm going to go 15 on that as well. So now we've got a lot of glow, but we need the glow to be more intense. So this is going to be, we'll name this 15 pixel blur, whereas here the eyes have a double 5 pixel blur. So I'm going to duplicate the 15 pixel blur, Command or Control J. I'm going to duplicate it a few times. I'm going to duplicate it once. Let's commit here. And then I'm going to go back to the original eyes layer and I'm going to reduce the opacity a little bit. Actually, I'm going to reduce the fill opacity. You'll see why here in a second. So I'm going to reduce the fill opacity to kind of blend it a little. Let's go maybe 50%. Then I'm going to double click on that eyes layer. And here's where we're going to work some magic. We are going to give these eyes a glow, a colored glow. So I'm going to go outer glow. And right here, this is exactly what I want, just this nice green glow. So normal blend mode opacity of 100%, 150 pixel size. And then the green color is this B9FFA4. That's what I want. And it's like that because I tested it out before I started the tutorial. And Photoshop remembered, hey, this is the last outer glow you had. So I'm going to hit OK. And you can see now we've got some cool looking like robotic wolf eyes where he's coming over and he's going to get what's his. Now, you may want to, despite the fact that we do have the shadow in front of him, or maybe because we have the shadow in front of him, paint a little green on the ground. So we could go something like green ground. And there's a million different ways to do this. I am going to once again use my tablet here. And I'm going to use kind of a sharp-edged brush. So I'm going to go brush, right-click. I'm going to just go up here because I'm using the tablet again. I never hold the pen close enough to the tablet to get a good connection when I'm right-clicking. So this is kind of good. And I'll just sample some of that green off there. And what I would do is do something like this. Like there it is coming off that eye. And here's the light coming off that eye, something like so. And I would probably set this to what's color dodge look like, what's screen look like, maybe screen. But of course, this needs to be blurred. So we go filter blur, Gaussian blur, 15 pixels. 15 pixels is probably pretty good. Okay. And then I would go filter and again blur up at this time with my favorite, the good old motion blur. But this should probably be maybe not quite negative 22, maybe like negative 15. So it's kind of going across the pasture a little bit more, something like that. Hit okay. And this needs to be a little bit more intense and snappy here on the ground. So I'm going to double click green ground and I'm going to say, you know what? I may push you up to like linear dodge, maybe color dodge. And I'm going to say, look, underlying layer, we want to take you out of some of the shadowy areas. So I'm just holding down Alt or Option and pulling that black handle back just like so. And maybe something that'd be fun is shut off the red channel and shut off the blue channel. And that gives us kind of this crazy green, which is kind of epic. Maybe I'll say okay to that. And I'm going to duplicate this layer. I'm going to try something here. And this layer, I'm going to double tap. I'm going to uncheck transparency shapes layer. And I'm going to reduce the fill opacity. I'm going to go back to the other green ground. And here, I'm just going to reduce the regular opacity. So we're kind of getting this green craziness. Maybe we could select them both. Command or Control G, group them together. Eye, ground, color. And mask this. So add a mask to this, go over it, right click and get a nice big soft edge brush. And again, you want to reduce the opacity quite a bit here. And I'm just going to paint with black and just go over some of the edges a little bit. You know, these sheep on the foreground, they probably shouldn't have too much green in front of them, but something like that. It's super duper subtle in there, but it'll be the kind of thing that if somebody notices it, it'll be like, oh wow, that's kind of cool. So at this point, a couple things left to do, and it's all color grady type stuff. We'll add like a channel mixer, maybe check on monochrome and try setting this to like the multiply blend mode, maybe reduce the opacity a bit. Something like that's kind of cool. We may want to do more clarity or dehazing type stuff, but I don't know. I kind of like the haziness of it. It's maybe a little bit too green for me, so I might go into maybe just throw an overall hue saturation adjustment and just try to swing all the colors of the composite one way or the other. So I can swing it that way to the blues. I can swing it back here, get it more pink, get it more sort of midnight blue, reduce the saturation, and then I have something that's more in the night. You know, with the wolf, that's kind of cool. Or if you want something that's more green, you can always do that. You bring some of that color back, or some of the lightness back, I'm sorry. Some of that green, and, you know, reduce the opacity a little. I don't know. I don't know that I like that much. Maybe we'll just throw a little color balance on here and just infuse a little bit more blue and cyan into it in general. Highlights, a little blue, a little cyan. I think that might look good with the overall color that we've chosen to kind of play with here. So something like that is kind of neat. A little bit of green, and then of course reduce the color balance, opacity just a little bit to blend it together. And you can see there we have this cool finished composite-y effect here in Adobe Photoshop. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If you did, make sure, of course, you subscribe and turn those notifications on. And if you did create this, I would love to see it. Upload it to your Instagram. Tag me in it. My Instagram handle is @tutvid. I would love to see what you made. Give you a little bit of love over there. That would be super cool. And if you enjoyed this video even more than that, check out this other tutorial I have on creating the City in a Cup photo manipulation composite. Just we had a bunch of fun doing it. I think you'll really enjoy it. There's a link there on the screen now. And just a reminder that I love all the people, but I especially love people just like you who stay here and watch these videos all the way to the end. Ladies and gentlemen, that's it. Get it, got it, good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one.
And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day.